Hello everybody, and welcome back to another video. And today, this is my airport update for early October. In today's airport update, you might find something really different in this video, because where I'm filming right now, it's in a different infrastructure and a different atmosphere, I should call it. And that's because instead of filming in the basement as usual, I'm actually filming this in my living room in my house. And the reason why for this is because today's airport update is something very, very different that no one has asked for, but I decided to do this for one reason. And let's get into today's video. So I'm going to be explaining about why I did this airport, what I did this for, and how I had to build this airport. So basically what I did to this airport is that I made this airport very different. It's not Maple Syrup City International Airport, and instead it's actually a tropical airport, so a summery tropical airport. And I know it's fall right now, and I should be doing an autumn airport update, but I kind of missed summer a little bit. Like, summer was so fun. Sometimes I still think about swimming. I still go to programs where they have swimming activities indoors, so that's where I'm going. I think I'm going there like next week, but I really miss swimming like outdoors, because that's where I prefer to swim, either in a pool or the beach, but I love the beach a lot. So this airport is actually built on an island, a natural island. Kind of like a Kansai Osaka. Well, that Japanese airport is actually built on an artificial island built by the Japanese. But this island that I made over here, it's actually based on a Hawaiian airport. So this is kind of like Honolulu I made, but more different. So today's airport is going to be called Tropical Lana Island. Again, that's Tropical Lana Island Airport. So Tropical Lana Island Airport is a fictional submarine-based airport that's based in Hawaii, but they kind of made this a little bit more like California. This is very similar of the airport I made in the summer, which is Tropical Lana Beach International. I'm using the same name, but I changed the beach to an island just because I love Tropical Island Paradise a lot. I love going on vacation a lot, and today's video, this is just gonna get me a little bit excited, but not too excited. I'm not quite sure if I'm really gonna go away in this October, but we'll see about it. It's very hard, even though there's some benefits that we are getting. But anyways, what this airport is actually about is that, like I said earlier, this is in Hawaii. This is named Tropical Lana Island International Airport. And in today's video, we're going to be using this airport for a different update. And I won't be using this airport again for a while now. So I might use this airport again somewhere in December or January. And that's very far away, even though December is like 2 months away, and it's October right now where I'm filming. But anyways, we're gonna get started right to the video over here. So if you can see this blue carpet that I made here, it's not me, it's decoration. So you can see the blue carpet here. So and this is the runway over here where the American Airlines aircraft is. That is the runway, and this blue carpet here is actually the ocean. So that's actually like a tropical paradise ocean, but in reality, this ocean would be like light blue, crystal blue ocean. So more like a warmer tropical ocean with coral reefs in it. We're gonna make sure this is a great environmental one. Yeah, so this is a pretty decoration, and this is why I put the runway next to this blue carpet. So I can make this look like a tropical ocean right next to the airport. So like I said earlier, this is built on an island. So we're gonna get started right in today's video with our aircraft. So I put like almost all the aircraft collection I got, but I left a few back in the basement. So to start this airport update, here we have an American Airlines Boeing 777-200ER, and this is just landing from Dallas-Fort Worth. Next in line here we have a Cathay Pacific Airbus A340-300 in a member of One World livery, and this will be heading out to Hong Kong. Just getting its engine started right now, here we have a Qantas Airbus A330-300, and this will be heading out to Sydney. Now, I know Qantas does not really bring A330s across the Pacific Ocean, but if you never knew this fact, this is the only Qantas aircraft I have. And besides, I really love the style of their A330 in the Qantas livery, so I just wanted to use this as a fictional route. And my airport is totally fictional, so I can do anything I want. If you want to make a real airport update, say for example, I'm making Honolulu International Airport, then this over here might not be even, the A330 might not even be here. I'm not quite sure if Qantas really goes to Honolulu International Airport. I have total confusion right now. But I just wanted to do what I wanted to do since it's a fictional airport. I never wanted to make a real life airport. I'm planning to make Toronto Pearson International Airport, but I'm gonna need to use specific aircraft in it. So far, I only have two specific aircraft, and that's Air Canada. And I need to know what routes Air Canada brings their 777s to. So I'm really so glad that I can make up my own fictional airports and just get creative as I can with a great creative mind, create airline routes, and even use my fictional airport as a hub. So later in this video, I'm actually going to tell what airline this fictional airport is going to be a hub for. So stay tuned. I do apologize for the camera flash and also the darkness, but I needed to use my camera flash just because it's just a little bit dark of where this model is. But the other models are in a sunlight area, so they can be seen very perfectly. But for this model, we just needed the flash, so I'm sorry for that. Anyways, here we have a Southwest Airlines Boeing 737-800, and this is just getting ready. And this will be heading out to Los Angeles International or LAX Airport. Holding short right behind the runway 6. That's the runway I just made up for this airport. Here we have an Air Canada Boeing 777-200LR. And after the American Airlines gets off the runway, this will be departing out for Calgary. And here we are at Concourse A right now. So we got two Star Alliance members parked right next to each other. So over here in the right side, we have the United Airlines Boeing 777-200ER. And this just arrived from Chicago O'Hare. And right next to him, here we have an Air Canada Boeing 777-200LR. And it just pulled into the gates. And as you can see, if you can see the Lego block over here, this is gonna resemble a crew member bus. Where the passengers are gonna get off and then they're gonna get into the bus there. Some passengers are gonna get off at the back of the aircraft. And this guy just arrived from Vancouver International Airport. On the main focus right now, here we have a KLM Boeing 787-9, and this just arrived from Amsterdam. Now, this is very exciting news for KLM because KLM just turned 100 years old. So this is the world's oldest airline still operating. From this day, from the year 1919 to the year 2019. So it's a really, really happy, exciting birthday for the airline. I'm wishing the airline a huge 100th birthday. On Twitter, I posted a tweet about this model and shared it to KLM. KLM was very excited, and I mentioned the airline's Twitter account at KLM. And then KLM replied that, hope you are having a great day ahead, and they said also, thank you so much. So that's really, really nice what they said. I'm hearing that KLM has really, really nice crew. It's also a great Sky team member, as this airline has a huge joint venture with F France, as well as the members of Sky Team, including my favorite Sky Team member, which is Delta Airlines. And speaking of Delta Airlines, here's something exciting in this video that I'm looking forward to show you guys, so stay tuned. But anyways, I'm really, really so glad in my heart that this airline is still operating. I'm wishing KLM a huge, great future ahead. And I really, really love to see KLM at my home airport of Toronto Pearson. So I think KLM brings either 747 or 777, and KLM, I think they come at lunchtime and they leave in the evening. I don't know about KLM because I mainly focus on Terminal 1 at Toronto Pearson rather than Terminal 3, as Toronto has two terminals. And Terminal 1's for Air Canada and Star Alliance members, except Emirates. And Terminal 3 is for the other airlines that are not part of Star Alliance, so like Oneworld, SkyTeam, and other airlines that don't even have an alliance, as well as low-cost airlines like WestJet, Caribbean Airlines, etc. So yes, I'm really, really so glad that I'm happy right now. So anyways, happy 100th anniversary KLM, with all the great aviation enthusiast excitement. Finally, we are moving on to the Concourse D, despite that this is actually a remote stand I made up here. And I know this needed to have gates because this airport is actually something special, because this airport that I have created right here is actually a hub for Delta Airlines. So this is really, really exciting because I really love Delta a lot. I just want to fly them again someday, but I won't fly them this year, despite that I might be going to the USA. I like flying Air Canada a lot, but hopefully one day I might probably be like already in my late teen age, or I might be like even a grown up. So hopefully one day I get that chance to fly Delta Airlines again. I do often watch videos of aircraft spawning in Atlanta, which is Delta's main hub and home to the world's busiest airport. Just to see a Delta Airlines aircraft around the airport. I also like to look like at a few Delta hubs, such as New York JFK, Detroit, Salt Lake City, as well as Los Angeles, which is shared with Delta's other teamed up airlines with American Airlines and United and Alaska Airlines in a focus city for Southwest and Los Angeles International. But this is really, really exciting as I'm using Delta Airlines to come to this beautiful tropical airport. As I know, Delta Airlines flies direct to Honolulu from Honolulu to a lot of destinations. As Delta Airlines also flies direct to Tokyo Narita, which will be ending soon. As Delta Airlines will move from Narita Airport to Haneda very soon. So that's going to be a big change for the airline. Anyways, here we have a Delta Airlines Boeing 767-300ER, what I'm showing right now. And this just pulled into its gate after arriving from New York JFK. And right next to that 767, with tourists getting off and getting into the bus here, here we have a Delta Airlines Airbus A330-300, and this just arrived from Atlanta. Thank you so much for watching today's video. I really hope that you enjoyed this video a lot. Now, I have nothing much to say, but since this is a special video, I want to give you a little bit of detail that this airport does not really have details, as they're all left in the basement where I usually film my normal airport updates, like Maple Syrup City International Airport, which I'm currently doing for the autumn season. And in this airport, I don't really have much detail. The only details I have is the one only service airport vehicle. So like the airport service bus that you see with the Delta Airlines A330-300 over there. I actually also use that for the Air Canada aircraft at the same time. So that's the same Lego piece bus that I was using. If I used to have palm trees, but now they're missing, so fake build palm trees, would have been better to put them like near the Delta Airlines aircraft, kind of like make it look like more like a tropical island airport and to welcome tourists. Sadly, this airport all doesn't really have any much details, but it was still a clever idea to like use the runway right next to the blue carpet, as the blue carpet is supposed to resemble like an ocean, even though tropical ocean should be like light blue, kind of greenish, like light blues to make it look like more warmer tropical coral waters, I should call it, like tropical oceans. But anyways, guys, I'm so glad that you watched today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Here's a list of things that you're gonna do after the video, which I highly suggest you. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you are new here. Don't forget to hit that notification bell. And third, check off, follow me on Twitter right now. Canadian Proud Aviation 10, same thing as my YouTube channel. I will post a lot of great tweets about this. Thank you so much for watching today. Once again, subscribe if you're new, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.